Hi friends,
I welcome you to my YouTube channel Govind Narayan Purohit, wherein we are discussing the various topics on veterinary obstetrics, veterinary gynecology, veterinary andrology, and you can scroll through the playlist to find the topic of your interest. I am highly thankful to all those who have subscribed to my YouTube channel. And hey, if you are visiting for the first time, kindly do not forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon and turn on the notifications so that you receive the notifications of our videos very fast. Friends, in our today's talk, we discuss how to perform pregnancy diagnosis in sheep and goats using transabdominal ultrasonography. You see, pregnancy diagnosis in sheep and goat is difficult by abdominal palpation or abdominal palatement before 3.5 to 4 months, and one cannot just put his hand in the rectum, so transrectal palpation is not possible for the sheep and goat. Now, many sheep and goat owners might be interested in knowing about the pregnancy status of their sheep or goat, and transabdominal ultrasonography is the easiest way and is the least invasive method for pregnancy diagnosis. Now, if one needs to perform the pregnancy diagnosis earlier than day 40, so between day 25 to 40, one would need the linear array probe of frequencies 5 to 7 megahertz frequency. But if you are going to perform the transabdominal ultrasound, then you need a probe between 3 to 5 megahertz, maybe a convex probe, and sometimes even you can use the linear array probe for transabdominal ultrasound examination for pregnancy. Now, I tell you, it's the easiest method of diagnosing pregnancy in sheep and goat. And we will talk how, right? Now, the first thing for ultrasound examination is the patient preparation and the probe placement or the placement of the patient. Now, one can examine both sheep and goat in a recumbent position or even in a standing position. The probe is placed between the limb in a standing position, just ahead of the thighs and just ahead of the bladder, and then one has to make the probe move in a W fashion. You come from here to here, go back like this, come from here to here and go back like this, so that you rest assured that you have examined both sides of the abdomen, especially when the animal is recumbent or maybe even when the animal is standing, right? So for preparation of the patient, the only preparation needed is you have to clip the hair, especially in sheep and even in goats having very long hairs. So you have to just clip the hairs, and then you can apply a gel over the probe and place the probe directly on the abdomen. But mind it, if the animal is pregnant less than 40 days, you will not be able to find signs of pregnancy. So you can just say yes, if you have not found anything, you can say the animal is not pregnant about day 40, right? Then what could be the sonographic findings when you are performing a transrectal probe? Of course, you can find the fetal fluids, and inside the amniotic vesicle you can find the fetus proper, and you can just measure the amniotic vesicle, you can measure the fetal head also. And then this is again a late pregnant goat, day 80, you can see the fetus, you can see the fetal fluids, and you can see the fetal parts also when you are examining thoroughly. Then the very first thing which one can visualize by putting the probe on the abdomen is the cotyledons. You can just change the frequency and then you can see more, because the cotyledons are closer to the uterine wall, so they appear. And then if you change the frequency, if you reduce the frequency, the rays will enter more deeper, and then you can see the parts of the fetus or maybe the fetal structures, right? Then, as I said earlier, even using a trans, this was with a linear array probe, and this one is with a convex probe or the sector probe. So the very first finding you will find is the fluid, black anechoic fluid, and the cotyledons, which are fully echogenic or maybe having a echogenic boundary with anechoic fluid in the center. So you can say the animal is pregnant or not. Then you can also visualize the fluid and the amniotic vesicle, the fetus proper, or the fetus along with the attachment or the umbilical cord, and then you can see the other structures also. So mind it, and then when you perform, you will, if the animal is advanced pregnant beyond day 70, you can find the fetal bones, which are echogenic, highly echogenic, and they appear white, and then you can sometimes find the reverberations because of the bones, right? So it's damn easy. You can perform it without much of specialization, and anyone can perform the pregnancy examination of sheep and goat. Now, the different fetal structures that appear in ultrasound, fetal fluid appears at day 20 to 25 by transrectal probe. Fetal heartbeat appears by day 21 to 23 by transrectal probe. And the fetus itself appears by day 25 to 30 using a transrectal probe. But when you are having only the transabdominal probe or a convex probe, the first thing that will appear is the cotyledons. They will appear between day 40 to 50. And there are reports which say that you can predict the gestational age based on the cotyledonary size, or maybe the biparietal diameter or the crown rump length, and the fetal bones, they appear by day 70. So you can say whether the animal is pregnant or not, right? Now here you can see practically how it is being done. The goat has been laid on a table, and the legs have the area have been shaved, because many a times goat have very long hairs, or maybe sheep are having plenty of wool. Shear them, clip the area, and then apply a gel over the probe, and then you can just after applying the gel, the probe is just placed. This is the area of the udder, and just ahead of it, it is placed near to the limb, and then it is moved in a W fashion, so that it's moved from here to here and then back to other side, so that you cannot just miss any of the fetal structures. Predicting the fetal viability based on the ultrasound is easier, because you can detect the fetal heartbeat, but predicting the fetal numbers is really difficult. One should because you can see the same fetus from both the sides, right? Then this is the actual ultrasound being carried out for the same goat. You can see here the fetal fluid, the anechoic fluids, the fetal bones, and this is the fetal heartbeat. So you can just see the fetal heartbeat, and you can also see the fetal movements. So one can with practice, you can just see the other structures of the fetus, and you can also see the cotyledons. This you can see, this is one of the cotyledon, and then you can say the animal is pregnant. So here you can see the cotyledons, the fetal fluids. Even if you don't find other structures of the fetus, if you find the cotyledons and the anechogenic fluid, you can very well say that the animal is pregnant, right? So if you like the sheet, this video, kindly do not forget to hit the subscribe button. You can contact me at my email gnpobs@gmail.com. You can find the other videos of interest in the playlist. You can go there and you can search for other videos of your interest. So friends, kindly share the video, give your likes, give your comments, and do not forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to subscribe to my channel. So thank you very much. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.